Oh boy, it's swell to say,
good morning, USA!
Good morning, USA!
Dad!
You'll never believe it!
Really
you're, you're all gonna
one at a time.
Stan, the new TV guide came, and you'll never guess what. Barbara does Celine!
Huh?
So listen, I'm gonna need all your support to make sure everything goes smoothly for me. This could be the best night of my life, and I don't want to have any regrets. Like when I had the chance to take ecstasy at the 2003 Tony Awards and didn't. I should have, but I was sitting next to Alan Cummings and I got scared.
Whatever. Haley, you're up.
So, I think I finally figured out why you never want to talk to me about...
Next! Somebody go next!
Dad, you know how I've been working really hard with my a cappella group, Here Comes Treble?
My boy singing the greatest song ever written to the greatest men ever made. American soldiers. Steve, serenade me.
Oh, oh, say, can you see?
Just sing it like a normal person.
Oh, say.
Okay, got it. Still sucks.
I thought it was great.
Have you been standing there the whole time?
Mm-hmm.
That's weird. I had no idea you were there. Anyway, Steve, it's fine, but not nearly good enough for the ears of veterans. Tell you what, I'll take the next couple days off work and we'll get that song just right.
Thanks, Dad. I don't want to mess this up.
No, you really don't.
Annoying, both of you.
I love your new pet.
It's not a pet, silly. It's my meal for the big night. It's an ortolan, Francine. The ultimate French delicacy. It's so sinfully decadent that you eat it under a napkin to hide your sin from God. You actually drown it in amaretto, then save its life using bird CPR, then refill the pot with creme de menthe and drown it again. There is something so sweet about your hair today. I love it.
Thank you.
Stop! Take a break. I gotta shake my head in disappointment for 5 minutes. Well, I guess we can add $5 more to your tab.
$5? For Barbara Does Celine? No! Oh, no! Ridiculous! No, $499. Streisand comes expensive, or she doesn't come at all.
Forget it! I wouldn't pay that much to see Barbara do Celine! Or would I? Maybe if I was in the room with them, peeking from behind the curtain, and they didn't know I was there. How would it appear on my credit card bill?
Fine. Let it begin. Crab walk! Should've played ball.
No!
I've been in the shower all night.
Yeah, I don't get it. I thought people were supposed to sing better in the shower. I don't know, maybe the problem isn't you. Maybe I'm not a great vocal coach. That's it! See, Steve, the national anthem is about war, and you'll never be able to sing it until you've been to war.
Can you expand on that idea?
Certainly. Take the song Love in an Elevator. The reason it's so good is because Steven Tyler actually lived in an elevator the summer he wrote it.
But the song's called Love in an Elevator, not Live in an Elevator.
Steve, he's a rock star living in a kick-ass elevator. You don't think he's getting laid? Oh, and it's summertime.
I've always wanted to go to a Civil War reenactment.
It's not a Civil War reenactment. Those things are for historians and people who hate blacks. These guys are hardcore reenactors.
You in Vietnam, bitches!
We're reenacting the Vietnam War?
This chopper will take you to base camp!
The Viet Cong may be making their move tonight. We need a watchman.
Steve will do it.
Dad?
We're counting on you tonight, Steve. Leave the blade in the sheath so it doesn't get dull. Leave the cap on so it doesn't dry out.
Dad, I don't know if I can stand watch all night. You've kept me up for the past 2 days practicing singing.
Steve, this is an opportunity to step up and be a hero. Then you'll know what it takes to really sing our national anthem. Radio me if you have any problems.
I'll do my best, Dad.
I want more than your best, Steve.
What so proudly?
Ah!
Man, what a letdown!
You'll be killed if you go into that jungle, man. Hey, my hand on fire?
Dead. Everyone's dead.
The spirits are dancing all around us. Popping and locking, mostly.
Everyone calm down!
No!
We gotta get out of here, man. Let's just go to the snack stop and get some grilled cheese, man.
No, we have to save my dad. I let him down. Dad, can you hear me?
Steve, it's dark and wet. There's golf carts. You have to
Roger,
let me go.
You give me code now. 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 This is Michael Patrick King's first draft of the Sex and the City movie. It's 700 pages. You guys know that young firefighter I did last night? Well, his hose spattered all over my European mosaic floor, and I slipped in it. But it's okay, girls, because I landed square on the rabbit and found out what's up, Jack.
It was just the three of us now. We were headed up Fa Nangong River towards Gobbly Goo Bay.
Pine cones are grenades!
Ah! Crap.
Boom!
Oh, oh, my legs! It blew off my damn legs!
You can make it, Buckle!
Take the shot!
Not the face!
Oh my God, that hurt! Ow! Ow!
What were we doing here? Was it worth it? Just to become better singers? The only thing that made sense anymore was my mission. And I was alone. In hell.
Damn it! Stan gave me a fake code!
I know the code.
You will give it to me!
I will. For the bird. I want it set free.
Fine! You got what you want. Now give me that code.
4812.
4812? Wait, he used my pants size? Ugh, I'm disgusting.
Sorry, Haley. Roger tricked me. He said he was gonna dress me up as Mr. Wendell from the Arrested Development song.
Give me the real bird, Roger. Where is it?
Please, give me some rice. I'll do anything. I'll make you feel good. Steve, you did it! You saved me! I'm so proud of you!
I'll call you back.
You should have seen him. My boy, the war hero. Steve's gonna sing the crap out of that national anthem now, aren't you, Steve? The same way I don't talk about all the tang I got in college out of respect for my wife. Tons.
Let's hope it's not the Hell's Angels. Please welcome to sing our national anthem, Steve Smith.
Oh, say...
It's just us. Just let me keep playing.
Viet Cong! Viet Cong!
Steve, snap out of it.
Mr. Smith, can I speak to you in the hallway? Your son appears to be suffering from PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder.
But, doctor, that's impossible. He was only in a reenactment. Is that a thing?
I've never heard of it. I'd like to keep him here for treatment. He could be a danger to himself or others.
Nonsense. Steve! Where'd he go?
When I was out there, all I wanted to do was come home. Here, sometimes someone claims they're a friend, but they're really just an acquaintance. And then some friends are really enemies. I came up with the word frenemy.
How did you open the curtain? Tell me how you open the curtain.
Hey there. The war reenactment was yesterday. It's over.
For you, maybe.
Where are you headed?
Just gonna get a grilled cheese at the snack stop. I had a friend that wanted one once. Won't be back till Wednesday.
I know a place down the road with a great grilled cheese. Come on, I'll drive you.
No, thanks. I'm not looking for trouble.
Get off the fairway, you turd!
This is the thanks I get. A hero's welcome.
We were kids, man. Buckle couldn't find his legs. We were gonna go cruising when we got home. We were gonna go cruising in his Solara, man!
Glug, glug, best, best. Get ready, my tummy is your nest, cause I'm stepping in the best. Ah!
Shut up.
You know, Celine Dion is in the audience tonight. She's fabulous, but I'm better. Here we go.
You are my strength and I couldn't speak. You are my...
So, how'd the big night turn out?
It was... there's no word to describe it. Schmoobly-dong? That's not it, but it's close.
Wow. That actually does sound really good.
Yeah, I'd like that too.
You the boy's father?
Listen, guy, no one could get in or out of here because of that crazy kid, and we need carts.
That boy is a remorseless reenactment machine. I know. I made him, and I'm the only one who can get him out. Do you copy?
There's a stink finger, sir. They're all dead. I'm the last one.
I can do better. That's why I came here. It's the only place you were ever proud of me, sir.
It wasn't the war.
Stay back!
Easy, stink finger, easy. It wasn't the war that made you this way.
What do you mean?
Oh, Steve, it was me. I pushed you too hard, put too much pressure on you. But I only did it because I love you and want you to succeed. I did to you what America did to Vietnam. I tried to control you, but no longer. I'm pulling out of you, Steve. You were always good enough, Steve. I don't know where this low self-esteem is coming from, but you need to start believing in yourself. So go out there and sing. And any way you do it, I'm gonna love it.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light? Girl, I'm gonna rock you in Freedom Town tonight.
That's my neighbor's son.
You know, ooh, rocket's bursting in the air.